Hey, what is up, guys? Welcome to another episode of Kill or Love. This is part 5. To be honest, I for some reason can't not remember from last episode. I guess I have amnesia or something, but I can say things went down. I think what happened was Anna Anna tried to comfort us because Grace left us. I think that's where we're at. Maybe not. I don't know. Let's just get right into it. Dear Diary. I found him. It was beautiful. It was like fate. It was fate. As soon as I came to the city... Wait, what is this? Hold on. I already read this part. Oh my gosh. Hold on. I'll be right back, guys. What the heck? Wasn't that fun? I honestly do not remember where I stopped at, but I guess we're right here. Yep. Things on the ground had already gone out. They were black and unrecognizable. Let's go back home. Okay, Anna Anna. Haha, you're so happy, aren't you? And why wouldn't you be? I'm happy too. The happiest I've ever been. Me too, the happiest I've ever been. Really? Yep. Thank you, Jack. That means the world to me. We went away, hand in hand. But before we walked out into the grass again, I looked back one last time at the things I had burned. Something moved at the edge of my vision, up in one of the glassless windows. I looked again, but it was gone. This place is dangerous. Aren't there people here? You know what? There just might be. Bad people. We should get home as soon as we can. Yes. Home. Where it's safe. That little slut. I hope she had a good look at us burning all that trash of hers. That Jack burning it. God, I'm so proud of him. It hurts. I can't believe I miscalculated, though. I thought Grace was gone for good. Huh? But then there she was in our hallway asking where Jack was and what I had done with him. All this while Jack was right on the other side of the door. Can you imagine what would happen if I wasn't there? She would have knocked on the door and rung the doorbell, and she would have probably called out too. It would have scared Jack so badly I can't bear to think about it. Thankfully, I was wrong about everything to do with her. She hasn't called the police. I knew she wouldn't. I didn't think she'd come back at all. She was still as scared as a little lamb. Lamb. Oh my gosh. Her hand shook while she demanded I tell her what happened to Jack. He can't be in there, can he? She stepped forward, but when I put myself between the door and her, she backed off again. I wonder how she didn't pee herself in. She was so scared. Jack doesn't want to see you. What are you doing to him? No one's seen him since I went away. It's like he's disappeared. He's been here the whole time. God, what are you doing to him? Be quiet. What? I'm confused. She was making so much noise. I put a hand on her shoulder to see if she had the guts to slap it away. She just stood there. Jack is perfectly fine. He's happy and doesn't want to see you again. I know he probably hates me now, but at least let me see him. I have to at least see him again. So annoying. Loneliness has made her desperate, unpleasant. That's what being by yourself does. Look at dear Jack. We've only been together for a short while, and he's already such a sweetheart. He was so prickly before. If you see him now, he'll tell you he hates you. Do you really want that? No, I don't want that, but... Then go away. Oh my gosh, look at it. Discord again? Son of a biscuit. But look at those eyes. Oh my gosh, dude. It's as simple as that, don't you think? Even someone like you should understand. Why are you so... I thought we were... She swallowed hard. I have to see him. Anna, please. Being alone made you into a real biscuit, you know that? Well, what? Or did it? Were you lonely after all? It really makes me wonder. With how little money it took with you, I was sure you'd be living on the streets. But you're clean. You don't smell more than usual. I'm living with a friend. What does it matter? That's a lie. You don't have any friends. Grace gritted her teeth and glared at me. She wanted to run away in shame. She's so simple, so obvious, but she couldn't leave with Jack so close. So, where are you staying? So, who's cockadoodle? Are you sucking for rent? I'm not. Is that wrinkly old man you work with? It's nothing like that. I'm living with Don, but I'm not. Oh, aren't you? Then how are you paying back his hospitality? You don't have any money. You quit your job, too. I checked. I'm not paying back anything. Don't be shy. Oh, screw you. Move. How violent. It's a good thing I separated her and Jack when I did. And I have this girl's influence, and who knows what could have happened. She tried to shove past me, but I was a little surprised. In my pocket. Oh, I heard it. It was a knife. And Anna, that's... Yep. So don't dare touch me again. Oh my gosh, look how scared she looks. She's so scared. I might do something bad. I pressed the knife against the side of her neck. It drew blood. I couldn't help myself. But it wasn't a lot. I was not going to kill someone out in the open like that. I'm not stupid. Grace stood petrified. You can't do this. You'll call the cops? No, you won't. They won't believe you. They never do. Right? She didn't... No Discord, please. She didn't lash out for once. She must have finally realized how useless it was to try. So she shuffled away. I waved her off. It's only polite. She didn't even look back. Oh, what a mega biscuit, dude. But then she kept following me around, even after that. What a stalker. So I had Jack burn her things. I know she was watching. It was beautiful. Oh my gosh. No Discord. Now she'll back off for good. I'm back. Welcome back. Hey, easy. You'll trip. The moment she touched me, those long hours of waiting were painted over by warmth. It made me so happy. Something smells good. Is it dinner? Yes. Oh, you remembered. I'm so glad. Huh. I'd made a casserole. Anna set the table and I served it. Mmm. That was really tasty, Jack. Thank you. I wasn't happy with the meal. It was tasteless and the meat was tough. Anna said she liked it. She was so kind. I wish I could help more. What do you mean? With money, I guess. I was being serious, but she laughed. That made me feel a bit stupid. Oh, Jack, money's no problem now.
Oh, God. Here it comes.
Well, money at all. I told you already I've got a lot saved up. And rent here is nothing. Oh, okay. And Anna hummed contentedly. A minute later, she stopped. There's something you can do, actually. Really? Yes, really. Ah, but I'm not sure if you'd be up to it. Anything. I'll do anything for you. Okay, then. What is it? How can I help? Wait until before bedtime, okay? I nodded. Ooh, some action in the bed, some action in the bed. When I heard what she wanted me to do, I didn't take it well. I was angry, furious. I felt betrayed. What? Aw. You want me to... Yes, I do. But no. You said I'd never have to remember anything. You promised. I got up from the bed and started pacing from wall to wall, never looking at Anna. What she said hurt. How could you lie like that? Oh, baby. Please don't hate me. I was shivering with anger. I thought I might faint, but I didn't hate her. I couldn't, so I stopped walking and faced her. I know I said what I said, but this is important. Don't you believe me? There was only one thing I could say. Yeah, I believe you. Thank you, Jack. I love you. I love you too. And I'm sorry. Don't say you're... Here Anna honestly, she was sorry for some reason. Like a punch to the gut. Tugged at a memory. She always said, I know, but that's not what I'm telling you to remember. You must never remember that woman. Forget all of you have left of her. I can't take serious of that face. Then, what I want you to recall goes much, much further back. It won't be easy, but when you do, when you remember, our love will be the deepest it's ever been. Don't you want that? I do. I love you. I want that. I want to love you even more. Tell me what I should remember.
George Barbecue Foot Massage! George Barbecue Foot Massage!
And Anna embraced me with happy tears in her eyes. But she wouldn't let me. She wouldn't tell me what I needed to remember. She said it would be pointless if she told me. I had to remember it all by myself in order for me to sit down in front of the alarm clock every day for at least an hour. I was to do this while she was at work. I was to have my eyes closed. I was trying to dig back my memories far, far back. I did as ordered. But the first time I tried, the very next day, it was all so foggy in my mind that I couldn't even start. Thinking felt slow. It was like walking through molasses. I only made myself tired. Before I fell asleep sitting up, one last thought came to me. Was thinking always so hard? The second time, too, I gave up right away. I couldn't do it. But I had promised Anna Anna. The next day, I tried harder. My head hurt, and I felt like I was groping in the dark. Scared all alone, but I did it. I had promised Anna Anna. I waited further in. Oh, I wonder if he did this too much that it caused him to hurt his leg. Maybe he hurt his own leg. A flash of a smile made my chest hurt, but I kept going. For love, huh? Which one do I love? Which one do I hate? Things didn't used to be like this, did they? This feels wrong. Something went terribly wrong. I didn't make sense of it. Yeah, he hate Anna Anna at first. Oh, jeez. And then... Now he hates Grace, but he loves Grace, but he also loves Anna Anna. Yeah, that's confusing. Days later, while going back in my memory, I reached a wall. A dam. I felt I shouldn't try to climb over it, so I didn't. There were things out there I didn't want to see. So I went back to the puddle I'd been searching through. It was a stew of love and fear and hate, given and taken seemingly at random. It was a mess, but it was a mess in my head. I would make it make sense. Jack. I don't know how to say that. Yes, Anna Anna? I'm going to work. Aren't you going to say goodbye? Oh, bye, Anna Anna. And a goodbye kiss? We kissed. And Anna placed a hand on my forehead. Are you okay? You might have a fever. And you just give me a kiss right after that? That made sense. I can give you something for that. I smiled. I'm okay. It's just... What is it, trouble? You can tell me anything. Do you know that sandwich shop? Which one? Next to the store? I nodded. You want a sandwich from there? Yeah, if that's okay. Well, there's always a huge line there. Please, Anna Anna, it would mean a lot to me. Oh, how can I resist? Of course, darling, I'll get you anything. What kind of sandwich do we want? Do you want anything you pick? I'll get you something light. You're not getting much exercise. I don't want you to get fat.
Ha ha ha.
Oh. Well, now I feel sad. Is that alright? Yep. Great. And don't forget your remembering session. You've been doing those, right? Yeah. And? I frowned and shook my head. Nothing yet. Oh, well, it's not even been 2 weeks yet. You'll get there soon. I'm sure you will. Yeah. I will. And Anna pinched my cheek, kissed me again, and left. And I went and threw up in the toilet. Oh, God. I brushed my teeth and washed my mouth 3 times over. I can't go on like this. I couldn't keep living here. I waited 10 minutes until I was sure Anna was gone. Then I pulled back the heavy curtains. Down on the street, there was a single person looking sad and abandoned. I waved at her. She looked up and nodded and walked into the building. Uh-oh, this is not good. This is not good at all. Uh-oh. If Anna Anna returns at any moment, things are not going to go well. Hi, Jack. I was so happy to see her, I wanted to cry. Oh, Grace. We'd see each other in secret 5 days ago. I don't know how long exactly I had started counting the days again. That big cloud of confusion in my brain was gone. That wasn't Anna Anna's dog anymore. It was Anna Anna's fault. What else could she expect, having me dig around my past like that? But it was scary how close I'd come to letting go. If things were a bit different, I might have kept on being a half-mute idiot forever. I never would have let Grace inside. When I first heard Grace's voice again, I thought I'd finally snap. I thought I was hallucinating, but I opened the door and there she was. Grace. Grace, I'm so happy to see you. I thought, after your message, I thought I'd never... Don't say that. Don't say anything just for a minute. We put our arms around each other. We'd only been apart for a few weeks, but so many things had happened like that it felt like years. I knew it. You don't hate me. Ah, who could hate a face like that? Just look at it. Look at it. I didn't know what she was talking about, and I didn't really care. Only one thing mattered now. Let's go. Let's get out of here. I've been working out the courage to leave ever since I had become myself again. Stupid as it seemed, I was afraid of going outside. But with Grace here, I could leave. I could do anything. We can't. Huh? You're not going to leave here. Not yet. Why not? Do you have any idea what it's like for me to end here? I can't imagine, Jack, and I'm sorry. I'm so sorry I didn't believe you. You knew how dangerous Anna Anna was right from the start. That's all the more reason to get the hell away. I told you, not yet. There isn't something we can run away from. So I wish we could just pack up and leave, but Anna Anna is going to follow us wherever we go. God damn it! I stomped on the ground like an angry child. Grace was right. Anna Anna followed me here. If we left, she'd do it again. We have to report her to the... No, Jack, no police. They'd trust her first a million times over. I guess they would. Besides, I wasn't even sure if she'd done anything actually illegal. But what then? What do we do? I don't know. Why is this happening to us? Even as we talked, we kept our ears to the hallway. Though we both knew Anna Anna was at work, the slightest echo of her footstep was enough to make us jump. Why can't she just leave us alone? Why does she even want from you? I think I might have a clue. I told Grace about how Anna Anna was trying to make me remember stuff from years ago. But it was so long ago. Anything could have made her obsessed with me. Jack. What? I'm sorry to say this. I know you always hated it when I did. What is it? I had a feeling of what she'd say, and I didn't like it. You really do have to remember. I pinched the bridge of my nose. There was a big headache coming on right behind the eyes. I know. We can't win against her like this. Not when she knows so much more than we do. I know, all right? Do you think you can do it? I don't want to do it. I think I can. I never tried. Not seriously, not since those first few days. Good. Please do try. And thank you for not giving in, Jack. I know it must be hard. Do you need anything from outside? I can sneak something in. I don't have a lot, but no, I don't need anything. Anna Anna keeps me well fed. I put as much contempt as I could into those words. Are you doing all right, though? You don't have any money, do you? I think Anna Anna's got some stashed somewhere around here. Grace refused. We can't risk her noticing. And besides, I'm not doing okay. I'm staying with a friend. They're a big help. Oh. Alright then. So she landed on her feet. Made me happy to hear that. I'll be going now, Jack. What? Already? Anna won't be home for hours. She's not supposed to. We've got to be careful. And being here at all is making me so nervous I could die. You're right. Besides, we'll have plenty of time to spend together once this is over. Yeah. Just us two. We looked at each other lovingly. Then a door slammed shut somewhere in the building. I really need to go. Bye, Jack. Bye, Grace. I love you. I'd wonder if it was still okay for me to tell Grace I loved her, but the words went and said themselves. Grace stood on her tippy toes to kiss me on the cheek. I love you too. Cute. That was cute. She had to stand on her tippy toes. I haven't dated a woman that was shorter than me yet. I just roasted myself. Oh, great. Locking the door after her was one of the most difficult things I have ever done, but seeing her had given me the courage I needed. I felt I could do anything. And now, here we were, 5 days later, 2 secret meetings later. I couldn't go on. Grace, I'm sorry. You can't stay here anymore. I really, really can't. I'm at my limit. No, I'm way past my limit. I'm surprised I've still got it together. Oh, baby, I'm sorry. Have you made any progress? It was an echo of Anna's constant questioning. But Grace wasn't doing it on purpose. I told myself I kept my anger in check. No, nothing. I can't remember anything from that time. It's like one big blind spot. I can't do it. It's hopeless. If you say it's really hopeless, then I guess it's no use at all. You said the same thing last time, too, but I still made you try. It's my fault. You're in so much pain. It's not your fault. It's hers. I heaved a sigh. I need to pack a few things. Wait here. I'll be ready at 5. That's a no. Again? What? You can't mean... I want you to stay here, Jack. There's no way I can. Just a little bit more, I promise. She came up to me and felt my upper arms. You're so thin now. But you could still hold her down, right? A chill went over me. What do you mean? Aren't we running away? We can't run away. She'll find us again. And then what? I can't live like that. I'm always afraid. I'm sure you can't either. So you're going to... She couldn't mean... Grace whispered a yes. No! It's wrong. Plain wrong. Yes, it is. But what else is there to do? She backed us into a corner. It's practically self-defense. I guess if you look at it that way. No, absolutely not. My head pounded at the temples. I'm so happy you agree. I so wish we could do it today, but I need to prepare. Can you stand being here until tomorrow evening? Yeah. Perfect, thank you. Tomorrow Anna Anna has a morning shift and she'll be back by early afternoon. Let's go for 6 o'clock. Okay? Okay. Wait, how does she know that? How does she know that she works in the morning shift? What? Please, I have her immobilized by then. Immobilized? How? I was already swept up in this plan. I didn't think twice about Grace said it anymore. I'm more immobilized, the better. The more immobilized, the better. If you just sat on her... What? That'd be alright, I guess. But tying her down would be a big help. And if you could knock her out, that would be amazing. hold the phone. What is going on? She just wants all of a sudden to attempt somewhat murder or some, like, harassment. That makes no sense. I'll see what I can do. Thank you. I'll be outside in the hallway when she's all tied up or passed out or whatever, shout so I know it's safe. Alright, okay. Alright. And then what will you do then? To answer, Grace took a small knife out of her pocket. She turned it in her hand a few times. Only then I did realize the full weight of what she would do. And only then did I realize how she didn't seem bothered by it. Grace, what happened? What do you mean? This isn't like you. The Grace I know. I hesitated. What did Anna do to you? Grace's good mood seemed to evaporate. She pressed her face against my chest. She did a lot. I felt like I was hurt, and I promised myself that it would never happen again. Blah, blah, blah. She took you from me, too. That's the only thing I really can't forgive. Imagine how happy we'd be if she never existed. This escalated so fast. It's not even a joke. I put my arms around her. I get it. Then let me do it. Give me the knife. I don't want to see you do this. Maybe I'll be able to work something out, I thought. Maybe it won't have to lead to bloodshed. I hated the sight of blood. I'm sorry, Jack. This is something I have to do. No, it's not just that. The truth is, I wanted to do it myself. It's nothing will ever feel... God, I can't read. I leaned in closer, but she stopped me before we kissed. I love you, Jack. I love you, too. Her skin felt hot. She was giving off heat like a furnace. Are you scared? Yeah. Please don't be. One day we'll look back on this and laugh. I don't think we're going to be laughing if we're going to be tying up someone. I think it's more of a scarring memory. I wake up with a bitter taste in my mouth. One day we'll look back and laugh. I'm sure as hell not laughing now. That's a good thought to have. What the? Oh, it's you. Don't sneak up on me like that, Christ. You should laugh as much as you can, you know? It helps reduce stress. It's hard to find things funny with you around. Do you have to come here so often? I see more than enough of you in my dreams. That long, shameful month I spent with her keeps coming to me while I sleep. It's souring my mood. I can't even pretend it around Anna Anna anymore. Maybe I should write about it in the journal after all. No, screw that. It'd be too embarrassing to write down. Jack, that's so sweet. Huh? What is it? So you dream about me? I have dreams about you too every night. Yeah, but mine are nightmares. Yeah. Looks like someone's cranky from having just woken up. You better not be so rude to your doctor, though. He's not as nice as I am. He might kick you out if you misbehave. I'd seen him do that. That's fine. I'd be happier out on the street. Do it, do it, do it, do it. The doctor comes along soon enough. He has good news for me. He says, looking good, Mr. Friday. What was his name? James Friday, I think. Far better than before. Your blood pressure's fine and other things too. It's great news, doctor. My attention is split between what he's saying and what I see in his coat pocket. It's glinting. Is it a pen? No, it's not a pen. It's something else. My heart beats faster. Thankfully, I still remember to ask an important question. So, when can I leave? Yeah, when are you going to release me? Doctor scratches his head and counts on his fingers. Wednesday next week? Next week? Yes. Wow, thanks, doctor. You're welcome. It's way earlier than I expected. I prepared myself for being here for a few more weeks. Thank you so much. Here. Put out a hand for him to shake. After a second, he takes it. I pull him closer and he stumbles nearly sprawling across my bed. It's a very sloppy handshake. Sorry, doctor. My bad. He coughs. It's fine. You really helped me. A lot. All in a day's work. So yes, next week. And then we got rehab. Rehab, doc? Oh yes. After you leave here, it's straight to the physical rehab facility for you. We don't have an inpatient facility here, but There is a great one on the other side of town. I'm sending you there. I'm not going home? No, of course not. You end up hurting yourself or with a limp. Is that what you want? No, no, no. That won't do. That won't do at all. He jots down some notes. Wednesday, that's in 4 days. Their nurses have been exercising you, right? They what? Huh? Exercising me? They haven't? He turns to Aunt Anna. What's this about, nurse? Excuse me? You should have been giving him some mild exercises. Well, you never told us that, doctor. Can't you tell by yourself? Doctor starts mumbling himself while making more notes. Christ, I really do have to do everything here, don't I? No, no, that's fine. Not like I pay to do these things or anything. And how long will I stay here, doctor? Raises his hand as if giving up on me. It's always that with you, isn't it? Look, how long you'll stay at the facilities up the people there. I can't tell you there. But don't hold your breath. I let out a laugh. Man, you're really going to milk me dry, aren't you? I bet you gotta deal with people over there, doctor. Don't you know how poor I'm poor as hell? He makes a grave face. The thought never crossed my mind. I live only to help people like yourself, Mr. Friday, so I don't appreciate hearing such accusations. I'd like you to be more careful about what you say. Understood? Understood. Good. And he rushes off, leather shoes creaking. Well then, and I only grabs of my right leg, the one that isn't broken. Hey, what do you think you're doing? It's exercise. You remember what the doctor said, don't you? Ah, right. Well, I suppose it's fine. She brings my knee up to my chest. And then, the joints of my leg pop. It's stiff. I haven't used it in a long time. How is it? Any pain? No. It's a little sore, but it doesn't hurt. Okay. She brings my leg back down. I'll keep going then, if you don't mind. Keep going as you please. She repeats the whole motion ever so gently. If this helped me start walking faster, I'm fine with it. Mm-hmm. Her hands are on me. While she helps me fold my leg up, her neck is so close I could. How do you feel about what the doctor said? Hmm? What did he say? That I'm out of here by next week. I whisper so the other patients can't hear. How does that make you feel? Are you angry? An honest smile doesn't break, but her fingers press against me more forcefully. I'm not angry, of course. It's nice that you're getting better. Oh yeah? And I'll still visit you at the facility. I'm sure you will. Oh, but what if they're strict about visiting hours? That'd be a bummer, wouldn't it? The first time in so long, I feel like I have the upper hand. It's going to my head. And who knows, maybe I'll tell them I don't want any visitors. To focus on your recovery? Yeah, of course. That's good. I want you healthy, darling. She stops exercising me mid-motion. I can wait. How long do you think I waited before? I'm a patient girl. Her fingers find her way up my inner leg. I can wait, no problem. Because after this is done, you'll be mine again. All mine. Forever. I grab her by the wrist. My fingernails dig into her skin. Ouch. You're hurting me. Shut up. How come? What makes you so... I'm never living with you again, you know that? Oh, sweetie. You'll do as I say. Of course. You still have grace. Well, yes, that's one reason. But there's one much dear to my heart. Do you know what that is? I glare back. It's that you love me. I don't. You do. You love me even if you don't know you love me. Deep down, you love me more than anything in the world. Just like I love you. You spent so long living all these lies that you've started believing them yourself. Don't worry, though. I'll help you remember all over again. She'll finally let go of me. Get plenty of rest. You'll have a lot ahead of you. She goes away, leaving me to myself, to my broken body. The night I dreamt of how I got to be like this. Oh my gosh, stop, Discord. Yep. Chapter 7. We did 2 chapters last time. Alright, guys. Uh, I have no idea what just happened there. What? Alright. Well, guys, that's the end of the video. That was part 5. This is seriously longer than I thought. And I never thought I'd be this far to completing this series, because I've actually never completed a series on this channel ever. So if you guys enjoyed it, subscribe if you aren't, and like the video, and I'll do more, which I'm still going to do more whether you like it or not, because I enjoy this series. And yeah, also I want to thank you for everyone that's actually watching these, if they are. So if you made it to the end, thank you. And guess that's it. So I'll see you guys later. Bye.